Greetings, St. Thomas. I want to thank you for your prayers, your support, and your patience during these summer months as we have worked to prepare our reopening plan. The amount of information that has been disseminated to us throughout these months has been incredible and difficult and sometimes overwhelming. But we thank you for your emails, your opinions, and all that you have done to help us to make the best, most informed decision we can. Before I turn this over to Dr. Dominguez, I think we should begin with prayer. We pray for the entire St. Thomas community. We pray for our students, our faculty, our staff, our alumni, our families. We pray for all those who are ill during this pandemic. We pray for all those who are separated from their loved ones, from their families and friends due to protocols and procedures. We pray for all those who have died, especially those in our community who have died separated from their loved ones. We pray that God will welcome them all into his loving embrace. Good and gracious Father, we ask for your wisdom and your understanding. Watch over us as we look to you for strength and for unity. I want to acknowledge several people who have worked tirelessly, really since March, to prepare for this plan. Dr. Dominguez and his team have created a flexibility in our academic plan. In our world, with the parameters around us shifting constantly, this flexibility is required. Mr. Rod Takis and his team have gathered together the best policies and procedures that will work to keep our faculty, our staff, and all of our students safe. And I want to thank our incredible buildings and grounds crew who have done such an amazing job of preparing the academic environment to make sure that it is safe for all of us. For more than 4 months now, I have live streamed the celebration of the Eucharist from this very chapel. Every single day, I have had the opportunity to pray for and to pray with the St. Thomas community and gathering more people beyond that. Gathering that community together, diverse and broad as it is, reminds me of our St. Thomas community. One of the things that is a hallmark of our St. Thomas education is that men of St. Thomas understand that they are not simply here for themselves. Our students know and love the work of Mr. Plata and his crew. They celebrate the great work and accomplishments of our teachers, the teachers who pushed them to even greater academic heights. And our students know to thank and be grateful for the example of their coaches and alumni who come back to show what a St. Thomas education can do for our world. What our men and our entire community need right now is to understand just how interconnected we are. It will take discipline to follow the procedures and policies in order to get us back on campus faster. Before I turn this video over to Dr. Dominguez, once again, I want to thank you for your prayers, for your support, and for your patience. as we work to find a way to be together again as one community, let us remember that we are one community, one St. Thomas family, students, faculty, and staff. The celebration of one lifts us all, and the sacrifice and suffering of one affects us all. During these months, many corporate commercial messages have gone out and have focused on a tagline such as, "We're all in this together." Going forward, I don't believe St. Thomas needs such a tagline. All we need to do is to remember that we are all one in Christ. May God bless St. Thomas and bless our community. Thank you.